Hi, I'm Dr. Phil Gilman, and I'd like to spend a few minutes going over some thyroid basics. Now, if you've been to my talk, I'm going to summarize a lot of what I talked about in my presentation. So I'm going to go over a number of thyroid secrets, and we're going to get right into the crux of the matter. The two major keys to thyroid success really get down to, number one, is this an autoimmune condition? And number two, is there a problem with converting your T4 to T3? Those are the two most dramatic things that I see when patients come into my office and they have not gotten any results from what they've tried so far. Now, Hashimoto's is actually an autoimmune condition where there's your own body is attacking your thyroid gland. Now, there are ways to test for Hashimoto's. There are a couple of autoimmune factors that can be tested for in the blood, and I routinely test for those, TPO and TG antibodies. Now, can you tell if a patient is autoimmune without doing these blood tests? Well, you can, in the sense that the typical patient is somebody that comes in that brings a bag full of supplements they've been trying, and they've gone to all kinds of doctors. They've probably, you know, gone to 5-10 doctors and they're still not getting results. However, I like to do the blood test because it's very good at identifying Hashimoto's autoimmune. Now, you also could have other autoimmune situations going on in your body also. Now, according to the Journal of Metabolic and Endocrine Disorders, 90% of hypothyroid patients, 90% of hypothyroid or low thyroid is caused by autoimmune thyroid or Hashimoto's thyroiditis. Now, medicine has no answer for that. Why? Because there currently is nothing to adequately address the autoimmune condition going on in your body that's attacking your thyroid gland. Remember that replacement hormone is the therapy that is used, but replacement hormone, also known as synthetic T4, is just replacing hormones. It's not doing nothing for the autoimmune situation going on in the body. So the question we need to really ask is, what is triggering this autoimmune response? Are there triggers? Well, yes, of course there are triggers. There are specific triggers, such as food triggers. Research shows, and my experience shows, that different foods can trigger an autoimmune response, especially gluten, what's in the protein found in wheat. Wheat has been found to contain the gluten molecule, which does trigger, it plays a factor in autoimmune thyroiditis or Hashimoto's. There may be other foods also, such as dairy and soy, that cause an inflammation process to go on in the body and cause your immune system to be triggered into an autoimmune response. There are other triggers, such as there can be bacterial triggers, there can be parasite triggers. I must also say there can be chemical triggers. There's a lot of toxicities in the environment, and these toxicities are stored in fat and tissue around organs, and so this can play a role with Hashimoto's, with autoimmune. Now, remember I said there were two components. One is the autoimmune response, which 90% of people with low thyroid actually have. The other factor is the conversion of T4 to T3. Now, this happens primarily in your liver. So the liver plays a very important role in converting 60% of the T4 to T3. Now, why is that important? Well, T3 is really the active thyroid hormone. That's the one that actually works. That's what's involved with metabolism, such as energy, weight control, coldness, mood, all of those, they're more responsive, your body's more responsive to T3 than it is T4. So there's a conversion in your body that your body converts T4 to T3, and 60% of that happens in the liver. In fact, my research has shown a relationship with the liver and thyroid. Now, another component is the importance of gut function, digestive function, your stomach and your intestines. Now, remember, 70% of your immune function is in your digestive tract. And so if you have an autoimmune problem or a conversion problem, we need to look at your gut function. Because remember, 20% of the conversion of T4 to T3 is in your gut. 70% of your immune function is in your gut. And for example, most of the serotonin produced in your body is produced in your gut. And of course, serotonin is real important for mood. So really, what it gets down to is our energy factors. Obviously, your thyroid plays a key role in that, but we also look at other factors such as mitochondrial function. Every cell in your body has a little energy factory called mitochondria, and we have to determine whether your mitochondria is doing its job properly. You also have adrenal glands that are really involved with any type of energy. Insulin resistance can play a role. In other words, that's blood sugar. If you have insulin resistance, it's hard to get energy into the cell, or hard to get food into the cell to produce energy. And then, of course, stress is real important. Because let's face it, stress, 90% of all diseases and symptoms are either directly caused by or aggravated by stress. Now, there are different types of stress. There's emotional stress, mental stress. That's what most people think of commonly. And, you know, we all have mental, emotional stress. But it is something that must be addressed and looked at. There's also chemical stress, all the toxins in the environment, the packaged foods that we eat where we become deficient in nutrients because they're just not there in the packaged food or the food we're producing anymore. And of course, there is physical stress. So stress is a major component. And you see what stress does. Stress is primarily in the nervous system. Stress then goes and affects your immune system. So when your immune system is not functioning properly, when you're under stress, that's going to affect your immune system. So your immune system may become autoimmune, it may become non-functioning or functioning poorly. So that's really important. And of course, since 90% of thyroid is autoimmune, stress must be addressed. Now we do brain-based testing and brain-based therapy to get your brain unstressed. Now, major factors, again, that we need to address: energy, joy, focus, and comfort. That's what I find that almost everybody that comes into my office is concerned about. They want more energy, more joy, more focus in life, and more comfort. Now, what I have noticed over the years, and I've spent decades working with people that have low thyroid. I published thyroid research over 25 years ago. So I have a track record of dealing with a lot of people. And what I've noticed is there's two types of patients that come in that cover pretty much almost everybody. Number one is the patient that has gone to the medical clinic, had a blood test, been told that they're low thyroid, and then given replacement medicine like Synthroid or synthetic T4, and doesn't notice any results. So that's the person that has a low thyroid diagnosis, a hypothyroid diagnosis, gets a medical drug therapy for it, and it makes little or no difference. The second type is the person that goes into the clinic with symptoms of low thyroid, has a blood test done, and they're told that it's normal. Now, what happens in both of these cases? The fact of the matter is not enough testing has been done to identify the problem of low energy or mood or focus. Now, diagnosis of thyroid dysfunction. My published research was on thyroid dysfunction. And there are additional ways of evaluating thyroid function. Some of them I've just gone over. And the real key is this. Do you have a thyroid disease or do you have a thyroid dysfunction? I'm here to tell you that almost everybody that's not getting results has a thyroid dysfunction. And what that means is that we need to find the pieces of the puzzle that are missing. Because with a dysfunction, a thyroid dysfunction, it isn't one thing. It isn't just a lack of T4 hormones. It's other factors. And we need to identify those, find the pieces of the puzzle. So come in, tell us your unique story, and together, we'll figure out what's going on and the best strategy to get your energy back, get your focus back, and get more joy into your life. So really, I'm looking for results. My patients experience results in terms of energy, increased energy, better mood, and better focus in life. So I'd like to thank you for listening to what I have to say. And when you come in, you can tell me your story, and together we'll figure out what's going on. Thank you.